Hi, it's Donna, your homegrown gourmet, part of the Gourmet or Good Enough team, along with my sister Diane. Today I'm going to show you a recipe using chestnuts. I'd like to make chestnut mushroom soup. I roasted the chestnuts this morning. I'll have a link in the description below so you can follow along in exactly how that's done. And then we have cremini mushrooms. I have some dried mushrooms that I'm hydrating. I have onion, leeks, butter, a little bit of olive oil, and then we'll add some thyme. So let's get started. To start, I've heated about a tablespoon of butter with a tablespoon of olive oil. And I'm going to add my mushrooms. I have about 12 ounces of roughly chopped mushrooms. You want to make sure you do a lot of salt and pepper. We're going to allow this to cook until the moisture is drawn out and the mushrooms are browned. Okay, most of the liquid has been drawn out. The mushrooms are nice and brown. I'm going to add my hydrated mushrooms. I have a combination of shiitake, morel, and porcini. I have a couple leeks that I've sliced up, white parts, a large onion that's chopped as well. I'm going to cook this until the onions and the leeks are a little soft and translucent. I'm going to go ahead and add one clove of minced garlic, and we'll give that about 30 seconds. As soon as it hits the pan, you can smell the aroma of the garlic. Oh, it smells so good. Add about a cup and a half of the liquid that I used to hydrate the dried mushrooms. That has a lot of flavor. I strained it and there's no grit in it. And then I have about 6 cups of chicken stock. Bring up the heat. I have about a pound of roughly chopped chestnuts. I'd like to add a little bit of thyme. I put it in some cheesecloth because I want to be able to fish it out when I'm done. We're just going to let this simmer until the chestnuts are nice and tender and soft, and the liquid reduces a little bit. So the soup has simmered for about an hour and the chestnuts are falling apart. I like to cool it slightly and then strain it. Remember to remove that thyme bundle. Then I puree the solids until smooth. You may need to add some additional chicken stock to the blender. You may need to do it in batches. Then just add that pureed solids back to your soup. Finish my soup once it's been pureed. I put 32 ounces away for later. I'm going to freeze it. But to serve, you reheat the soup, and once it's warmed up, add cream, stir that in, and then we're ready to serve. So we're going to ladle some of our beautiful, velvety, creamy mushroom chestnut soup. Look at that. Oh, yeah. Very nice. And then we'll add a few sauteed mushrooms right on top. That is the dish. I have my chestnut mushroom soup base that I can put in the freezer. All I have to do is thaw it out and add cream to it, and I'm good for the next meal. But today we're going to sample my beautiful chestnut mushroom soup with the cream and the sauteed mushrooms. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. Don't forget to give us a like on Facebook, follow us on Instagram, and be sure to join our YouTube channel, Gourmet or Good Enough. Ciao!